What's it like to be deported to a place that no longer feels like home?
The moment I stepped off the bus, I wanted to turn around because I felt like I didn't belong in Mexico.
Subscribe to Imperfect Paradise from LA Studios wherever you get your podcasts.
Get Lit is back at the Crawford in Pasadena. Join us for an electric night of spoken word performance featuring some of LA's best young poets. It's July 12th. Tickets at las.com/events.
It's another perfect day at my favorite local hidden gem.
Here to tell you about one of my favorite locations in all of Southern California.
Coming to you from my favorite slightly hidden spot in LA.
This is How to LA from LA Studios. I'm Brian De Los Santos. We've got something short but sweet for you today. It's the summer of Discover, and we've been all about discovering stuff around and about LA.
We'll spend time looking for the best beaches to lay out, the best spots for a cocktail or a mocktail, and cool places to check out some art. Last week, we took you on a couple of road trips to explore the great outdoors or some other spots you may have not been to. Today, we are staying local in the city.
Now, let's get outside. Yeah, we live in a big city, but as we stressed to you before, we are surrounded by a lot of natural beauty, and cool little pockets of outdoor zen exist all over LA. I've spent most of my life here, and I find there's always new places to explore, and plenty I've never heard of. A few weeks ago, we put a query out in the How to LA newsletter, asking where you like to go outside in LA to get away from it all. You all came through, and we collected a few recommendations. Let's start with a tucked away spot in Beverly Hills that's been featured in some of your favorite movies and TV shows.
Hi, my name is Kathy Malamed, and it's another perfect day at my favorite local hidden gem, Greystone Mansion in Beverly Hills. What makes it spectacular is the history and mystery that surrounds the mansion and its grounds, which was built in the late 1920s by Edward Doheny Sr. as a wedding gift for her son, Ned Doheny. Greystone Mansion is the epitome of what makes LA special. It has the rich history, a prominent family, the personality, the beauty, the views, and of course the movie industry tied to it. There are so many places to explore inside and outside of the mansion each and every visit. The ponds, the pool area, the view from downtown to the ocean, the wildlife. I hope you have the chance to visit and enjoy. I was lucky enough that growing up, Greystone was so close. It often served as the place to escape to, whether it was with friends to explore the gardens, enjoying nature and the spectacular views, or learning to drive stick shift in the parking lot many, many moons ago. One of my favorite memories was when I attended Catskills West, the camp, which is still in session as we speak. One night we had a sleepover on the lawn with our sleeping bags, with the moon and the stars shining so bright. It was truly a spectacular experience and a memory that lives within me.
That was Kathy Malamed telling us about her favorite spot, the Greystone Mansion. As Kathy mentioned, the Doheny family moved into the mansion back in the 1920s. The Doheny's are responsible for setting off LA's oil boom at the turn of the 20th century. The family is a staple of LA history, and Doheny Drive is also named after them. It's been a public park in Beverly Hills since 1971, but it's been a movie and TV backdrop going back to the 1940s. There Will Be Blood, which was actually loosely based on the Doheny family, was filmed here, as was Spider-Man 3, The Social Network, and so much more. The mansion is also a film location for some pretty famous music videos too, including the Divas' Mariah Carey's 2005 hit, We Belong Together. Next, we're heading to another Beverly Hills spot, this time in the center of the action. This calm slice of nature is right off Santa Monica Boulevard.
Hey, LAist, this is Nancy, a native Southern Californian, coming to you from my favorite, slightly hidden spot in LA, Beverly Gardens Park, otherwise known as the Fountain to Fountain Path. The mostly shaded path runs between Doheny and the Santa Monica Wilshire Boulevard intersection and is just shy of 2 miles end to end. It offers beautiful rose gardens, a cactus garden, Roman fountains, Grecian sitting area, and the friendly, familiar faces of your fellow neighbors. I began walking the path almost daily as a break from being stuck most of the day working in my home office inside. It's a chance to get some fresh air and enjoy a podcast or guided meditation along the way. The path is extremely pet-friendly, with ample open green spaces, doggy bags, and even pet-friendly water fountains. There are plenty of benches for taking a break in the shade, and even some interesting art installations. Check out the steel sculpture on the corner of Crescent Drive. On the path, you'll also pass the architecturally classic Beverly Hills Civic Center, and if you continue east, the famous Beverly Hills sign, as well as several historic Beverly Hills churches. The path has ample lighting, so don't forget to check it out at night as well. I hope to see you on the path someday.
Now, I gotta tell you, nothing is better than a post-workday walk. Thanks to Nancy Sherman Kim for the recommendation. We'll be heading up north to the mountains after this short break.
Think of your bucket list. One of those goals might be learning a new language for your next trip. You know, to have fun and understand the culture. To help you, try out this language learning platform, Babbel. What's cool about Babbel is its tips and tools. They're approachable, accessible, rooted in real-life situations, and delivered with conversation-based teaching so you're ready to practice what you learn in the real world. Babbel's quick 10-minute lessons are handcrafted by over 200 language experts to help you start speaking a new language in as little as 3 weeks. I'm actually learning Portuguese for fun, and I'm loving the app.
Valeu.
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 I'm obviously still working on it. Here's a special limited-time deal for our listeners. Right now, get up to 60% off your Babbel subscription, but only for our listeners at babbel.com/LA. Get up to 60% off at babbel.com/LA, spelled BABBEL.com/LA. Rules and restrictions may apply.
Hey, what's up, y'all? I'm Pendarvis Harshaw, host of the Right Nowish podcast. Every week, I talk to the people who are creating art and culture and spreading it to the universe.
As an artist, you always meet yourself. Every year, you're a different person.
Essentially, we normalize a space where you can show up as your authentic self.
Check out Right Nowish, rooted in California's Bay Area, speaking to you.
It's so many people of color, so many queer people. It's like I'm being celebrated in my fullness.
Available wherever you listen to podcasts.
And we're back. You're listening to How to LA. For our last listener recommendation, let's head north. It's in the Santa Monica Mountains, and it's actually the highest point of the range.
Hi, my name is Robert, and I'm here to tell you about one of my favorite locations in all of Southern California, Sandstone Peak, and why it's so magical to me. The peak is part of an easily recognizable ridgeline called the Boney Mountains. If you've ever flown into LAX from the north, you've passed over it while turning inland from Ventura. Look out the window next time you pass. It's very recognizable. There's two traits about getting to Sandstone that I enjoy. The first is its geographical location. The high barrier formed by the Santa Monica Mountains traps coastal clouds and fog, and as the temperatures rise, they snake their way up into the canyons and over the Bonies. I love the way they climb to meet me, bathing me in their soothing mist as they travel towards Simi Valley and beyond. Then there's other days like today, where the skies are crystal clear. From my vantage point at the peak, I can see over 80 miles in every direction. Saddleback Mountain near Irvine, San Clemente Island to the south, and Mount Baldy to the east are all visible. The second trait are the options for reaching the peak. While it lies along the 67-mile backbone trail, there are two close and adjacent trailheads that most people start from, Sandstone Peak Trailhead and Mishimokwa Trailhead. You can take the direct route, a 1,000-foot rise over a mile and a half. My preference is to take the longer 6-mile loop route through Mishimokwa and Upper Carlisle Canyon. You'll pass by rocky crags and the enormous Balancing Rock before passing through an elfin forest and chaparral. It was here once that I passed through such an infestation of ladybugs that the ground and plants were covered in these red lovelies. There's also a greater variety of plant life in the shaded canyon, from poppies and giant ryegrass to tiger lilies, depending on the season. Regardless of approach, the peak is there to greet you. The 2018 Woolsey Fire destroyed the steps to the summit, so you'll have to do a little scampering near the top. I find that the diversion of that and making sure I don't slip makes arriving at the peak even that much more special.
Thanks to Robert Bittner for letting us join him at Sandstone Peak. And now we've got some other recommendations for you too. Dance Park in Northeast LA is a great little hike, and we actually explored it in episode 12 of the podcast. Last time listeners sent in their favorite outside spots, someone submitted Ascot Hills Park near Lincoln Heights, which is amazing for sunsets. And my pro tip? Check out the Baldwin Hills Scenic Overlook, which you can access in Culver City. You can get fit on the Culver City steps or take the long route and access the Boneyard Dog Park at the other end. Just beware that parking can be a nightmare sometimes. That's it for today, y'all. I hope we helped you discover a new favorite spot. Thank you to everyone who filled out our form with their recommendations. And a huge thank you to Kathy, Nancy, and Robert for letting us share their stories. If you want to share your favorite place in LA, just send us an email at howtola@scpr.org. That's our email, howtola@scpr.org. All right, hasta luego. Stay cool, LA. This episode was produced by our awesome intern, Eden Tashoma. How to LA's other producers are Megan Botel, Evan Jacoby, Monica Bushman, and Victoria Alejandro. Our executive producer is Megan Larson, and I'm your host, Brian De Los Santos. Support for this podcast is made possible by Gordon and Donna Crawford, who believe that quality journalism makes Los Angeles a better place to live.
Get Lit is back at LAist with spoken word performances from some of LA's best young poets.
Yeah, okay, that is great.
Our featured poets are the West Hollywood Slam Team. It's a night to celebrate the best in LA poetry. July 12th at the Crawford in Pasadena. Tickets at LAist.com/events. See you there.